by virtue of the powers vested under the 1987 Constitution, the Omnibus Election Code or Batas Pambansa bilang 881 and other election laws, the Commissioner Election, Sitting and Bank as the National Board of Canvassers hereby declares the following candidates as the duly elected senators of the Republic of the Philippines in the May 9, 2022 national and local elections.
Robin Padilla, Lauren Legarda, Rafi Tulfo, Sherwin Gatchalian, Francis Escudero, Mark Villar, Alan Peter Cayetano, Miguel Zubiri, Joel Villanueva, JV Ejercito, Risa Ontiveros, Jingoy Estrada are now officially senators-elect with their six-year terms starting on June 30. They were granted a certificate and their hands raised by the members of the commission in a Filipiniana-themed ceremony with Senators Bongo, Pia Cayetano and Cynthia Villar, former Senate President Manny Villar, and actress Heart Evangelista, wife of Escudero, in attendance. COMELEC Chairman Saidamen Pangarungan paid special tribute to Padilla, who topped the elections. Padilla had been convicted for illegal possession of firearms in his younger years, but he was given an absolute pardon by President Duterte, which restored his political rights. Padilla pointed out the historical significance of his victory.
Ang akin pong pagkapanalo ay isa pong simbolo ng pagkakaisa ng mga Muslim at Kristiyano. Halos umabot po ang 30 taon. Wala pong Muslim na naging senador.
Comebacking Senator-elect Jingoy Estrada, who took the last senatorial slot, can only promise to live up to his campaign promises. Estrada is back with his brother JV Ejercito after they both lost in the midterm elections. Estrada had been freed after being allowed to post bail for a plunder charge in connection with the pork barrel scam.
At asahan po ninyo, sa loob ng 6 na taon, ang aking mga ipinangako sa taong bayan nung panahon ng kampanya, lalong-lalo na po ang pagbibigay ng trabaho sa ating mga Pilipino na walang trabaho ay maisa sa kotoparan.
Meanwhile, Senator-elect Alan Peter Cayetano claims to have received calls from at least 3 colleagues who are seeking the Senate presidency.
Lahat ng tumatakbong Senate president, tawag ng tawag eh. So ang masasabi ko dun sa mga tumatakbong Senate president, I hate drugs, I hate isabong, I hate inefficiency in government, and I hate it when we seem helpless. Actually, majority na tayo dito ngayon kasi nandito si Senator Cynthia Villar, nandito si Senator Pia Cayetano, nandito si Senator Bongo. So I know it's not a time and place for the Senate President. Yung tatlo ata ang tumatakbo ngayon na magsalita. But a strong, independent Senate that will help Malacanang when it needs help, but will also correct and fiscalize when they have to be told that something is wrong, is what our country needs now.
The canvassing board went ahead with the proclamation even without the votes from Shanghai and Lanao del Sur, as it won't be enough to overcome the lead Estrada had over 13th placer former Vice President Jojo Binay, which is about 1.8 million votes. For the poll body, the proclamation is but the culmination of the poll body's hard work to mount the elections, as he cited the lowest incidence of violence and the highest voter turnout in history.
I am proud to say that the Commission on Elections has successfully defended the sovereign right of the people to the democratic process of elections. This election has been accepted by most of our countrymen to be honest, orderly, and generally peaceful.
The poll body could only thank their election partners as they wish the senators well. But they still have work ahead, as the partyless elections will be decided after next week's special elections in Lanao del Sur. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.